Today we will start with differentiation. So we have topic differentiation. So differentiation means, differentiation is a process to find derivative of a given function. Means if we have given function fx and we need to find its derivative. So first we define derivative. Derivative of a given function fx means we have a function fx given and we need to find the derivative. So the derivative of a given function fx is denoted by f dash x or d upon dx of fx, and it is defined by means definition of derivative is defined by f dash x is equal to limit h tends to 0 f of x plus h minus fx upon h. This is the definition of derivative of a function. Means we have function fx and we need to find f dash x, where f dash x is derivative of function fx with respect to x. And definition is limit h tends to 0 f of x plus h minus fx upon h, means h is a parameter which tends to 0. Now we can define, suppose for example we have function fx is 1 and we need to find its derivative. Fx is equal to 1 is a constant function and we need to find derivative of this fx. So f dash x is limit h tends to 0 f of x plus h minus fx upon h. Since fx is 1 and 1 is free of x, means 1 does not involve x, so f of x plus h will also be 1. So we need to find f dash x. So we proceed, limit h tends to 0, fx is 1, so f x plus h is also 1 because it is constant function, 1 minus 1, f of x plus 1 is 1, fx is 1 upon h. Limit h tends to 0, 0 upon h. 0 is a, 0 means 0 is exact 0, and upon h, h tends to 0 means h is approximately 0, h is not exactly 0. So means h is some non-zero number, 0 upon some non-zero number will give 0, and so answer will be exactly 0. So what we find here, derivative of function fx is equal to 1 is 0, and we write it d upon dx of 1, this is 0, means derivative of function fx is equal to 1 is 0. This is a derivative. Derivative means f dash x. Now we can define differentiation, like differentiation. It is a process. Differentiation is a process. It is a process to find derivative of a given function fx. We have a given function and we need to find the derivative, then we apply the process, and that process is called differentiation. Means suppose we have some machine. This is a machine, this is any machine, input is fx and output is f dash x. And what is the work of the machine? Machine does differentiation. So we input fx and inside the machine process happened, that process is called differentiation, and output is f dash x. And this f dash x is derivative. Derivative of fx. And this is a given function. Given function. We take some more example. So we studied that f dash x is limit h tends to 0 f of x plus h minus fx upon h. This is a basic definition of derivative of function. This is called first principle. First principle. The name of formula is first principle. Suppose we take some example. For that we have some notations. If y is equal to fx, then we write dy by dx, which is called f dash x, or we write it d upon dx of fx. We read it derivative of y with respect to x. F dash x is the same, derivative of fx with respect to x, or derivative of fx with respect to x. This is a notation. We take some examples. Suppose we have fx is equal to x, and we need to find the derivative of this function. This is called identity function. Fx is equal to x, and we have to find derivative of this function. So we apply the definition f dash x limit h tends to 0 f of x plus h minus fx upon h. Since fx is h, means this depend, sorry, fx is x, and this depend on x, f of x plus h, because this x gives x, so we have x plus h. So we put into there limit h tends to 0 f of x plus h is x plus h minus fx is x upon h. This minus x plus x cancelled out, and we remaining with h upon h. Since h is a non-zero number, because h tends to 0, h is not exactly 0, h is approximately 0, so we can cancel it, and we obtain 1. Means derivative of this function is 1, and we write it derivative of x, this is 1. Similarly, we can prove by the same way, we can prove derivative of x square, this is 2x, derivative of x cube, this is 3x square. By the same definition, we can prove these results. Derivative of 1 is 0, derivative of x is 1, derivative of x square is 2x, derivative of x cube is 3x square. And similarly, if we generalize this result, we get derivative of x ki power n, this is n x ki power n minus 1. So we have the identity, derivative of x ki power n with respect to x is n x ki power n minus 1. By the same formula we can get this result or generalize this. Similarly, we can find derivative of 1 upon x, this is minus 1 upon x square. Derivative of root x, root x means x ki power 1 by 2, we will get 1 by 2 root x. Derivative of 1 upon x ki power n, and this is minus n upon x ki power n plus 1. These are results from this definition. Now we come to trigonometric function. Fx is equal to sine x. This is a trigonometric function, and we need to find the derivative of this function. So we apply first principle. F dash x is limit h tends to 0. F dash x means derivative of this function. We have fx as sine x, and we need to find f dash x, means derivative of sine x with respect to x. So definition is x plus h minus fx upon h. Limit h tends to 0. Since fx is sin x, so f of x plus h will be sin of x plus h, because sin x depend on h, depend on x. Fx is sin x, this x and here this x. So f of x plus h will be sin x plus h, because here x is replaced by x plus h, so this x is replaced by x plus h. Now we put into this formula this is sin x plus h minus sin x upon h. Limit h tends to 0. Here we have two options, either we open this identity or we can apply sin a minus sin b. We open this formula, sin x plus h, this is sin x cos h plus cos x sin h minus sin x upon h. Since we have identity sin a plus b, sin a into cos b plus cos a into sin b. We use this formula. So we proceed with limit h tends to 0. Now this and this, we take common from these two terms. If we write it together, sin x into cos h minus sin x and plus cos x into sin h upon h. We proceed from here. Limit h tends to 0. We can take common from these two terms. We can take out sin x. So sin x, and we remain with cos h minus 1. And next is plus cos x into sin h whole upon h. We separate it, first term upon denominator, second term upon denominator. Limit h tends to 0, sin x into cos h minus 1 upon h plus cos x into sin h upon h. And we have identity cos h upon h, cos h minus 1 upon h, this is 0. And we have again identity in limits sin h upon h when h tends to 0 is 1. So we use it. So sin x into 0 plus cos x into 1, we have cos x. Since limit h tends to 0, cos h minus 1 upon h is 0, and limit h tends to 0, sin h upon h is 1. We use these two results, and what we got, we had a function sin x and we started finding f dash x, and finally we got cos x. Means derivative of sin x with respect to x is cos x. Derivative of sin x with respect to x is cos x. Like earlier we started finding derivative of polynomial functions like 1x, x square, x cube, and generalized it, derivative of x to the power n is n x to the power n minus 1, and subsequent results are there. Now we have function sin x and we had to find the derivative, so we found it, derivative of sin x is cos x. Similarly, we can prove like derivative of cos x is minus sin x, derivative of tan x is sec square x, derivative of cot x is minus cosec square x, derivative of sec x is sec x tan x, and derivative of cosec x is minus cosec x into cot x. These are the derivative of trigonometric functions. Derivative of sin x is cos x, then derivative of cos x is sin x, derivative of tan x is sec square x, derivative of cot x is minus cosec square x, derivative of sec x is sec x tan x, and derivative of cosec x is minus cosec x cot x. We can prove some more results like derivative of logarithmic function, derivative of ln x, or we say derivative of log x with base e, this is 1 upon x. Again, derivative of exponential function e ki power x, this is e ki power x. Derivative of a ki power x, this is a ki power x ln a. We can prove these results from first principle, where a is positive and a is not equal to 1 by the definition of exponential function. Some more results, like derivative of 2 ki power x, we put it a is equal to 2, we get 2 ki power x ln 2. Derivative of 10 ki power x, we get 10 ki power x ln 10. Similarly, we can find the derivative of almost all functions. Now we have some rules of differentiation. Rules of differentiation. Suppose we have two functions, fx and gx, and we need to find the derivative of their sum. So we have sum formula. We need to find derivative of fx plus gx with respect to x. Then we can write it derivative of fx plus derivative of gx. We can prove it by same first principle. Derivative of fx plus gx means derivative of sum, this is equal to sum of derivatives. Similarly, we have difference formula. Difference formula, derivative of fx minus gx, this is equal to derivative of fx minus derivative of gx. We have fx and gx, we need to find derivative of fx minus gx. So this is equal to derivative of fx minus derivative of gx, means derivative of difference is equal to difference of derivatives. Third, we have product rule. Product rule, we have two functions f and gx, we need to find derivative of product fx into gx, product of two functions, or we can write it fg of x. So the definitions, or we can prove by definition, the result is gx into derivative of fx plus fx into derivative of gx. This is the product rule of differentiation. Like when we have two functions in product, then derivative will be gx into derivative of fx plus fx into derivative of gx. We cannot write derivative of fx into derivative of gx. And now we have next is quotient rule. Next is quotient rule. The derivative of fx upon gx, this is equal to gx into derivative of fx minus fx into derivative of gx upon gx whole square, where gx must not be 0. Where gx must not be 0, otherwise this will be not defined. So gx must be non-zero function, so that denominator is non-zero, so it will be defined. This is the quotient rule. Now we take some examples on this formula. Example is, suppose we have fx is x plus sin x. We need to find the derivative of this function. So we write f dash x means derivative of x plus sin x. By some rule, we can separate it, derivative of x plus derivative of sin x. And from the first principle, we got the result that derivative of x is 1 and derivative of sin x is cos x. So, derivative of this function, x plus sin x is 1 plus cos x. Similarly, if we have e to the power x upon log x. With base e, f x is e to the power x upon log x. We need to find its derivative. So this function is cosine. So we need to apply cosine rule. So f dash x is log x as it is, derivative of e to the power x minus e to the power as it is, derivative of log x upon log x whole square. So we get the result like log x into derivative of e to the power x is e to the power x. We have result e to the power x into derivative of log x is 1 by x upon log x whole square. We can simplify it and we get x log x into e to the power x minus e to the power x upon x log x whole square. This is the derivative of this function. We applied cosine rule and we get that. We can take common e to the power x. If we get common, then we are remaining with x log x minus 1 upon x log x whole square, the derivative. If we take some more examples, next example, next we take next identity. We had sum rule, difference rule, product rule, cosine rule. Now we have chain rule. Chain rule applies when we have two function, the composition of two function. Like we have function hx as fog of x means fx of f of g of x. We have this type of function and we need to find h dash x. Here h is a function fog. Fog means f of g of x. So domain of means in case of fx, x is replaced by gx. So how we find derivative? The identity says we need to find derivative of hx. This notation means h dash x means derivative of hx with x, d upon dx, and we put f of g of x. The chain rule says first we differentiate f with respect to gx. First we differentiate f with respect to gx and then we will differentiate g in with respect to x. Like we can write it d of f of g of x with respect to gx into derivative of gx with respect to x. We can write it this. If we cancel out this, then we get this. So we have f dash of gx into g dash of x. So we have finally identity derivative of f of g of x, that was hx. This rule is called chain rule. Chain rule says derivative of composition f of g of x is f dash gx into g dash x, means derivative of x with respect to gx and then derivative of g with respect to x. We take one example on that. For example, consider fx is equal to, or you can take hx, hx is equal to sine of x square. X square is itself a function and then sine of x square. In case of sine x, we replaced x by x square. So we have two functions. One is sine, other is x square. So we need to differentiate h, h dash x. So we need to differentiate sine x square with respect to x. So we can write like we will differentiate sine x square with respect to x square and differentiate x square with respect to x. First we will differentiate sine x square with respect to x square and then derivative x square with respect to x. So derivative of sine x square with respect to x square is cos x square, because derivative of sine x with respect to x is cos x into derivative of x square. We got the result with respect to x is 2x. So we have finally 2x cos x square. So this is the derivative of sine x square with respect to